morning, everyone! Welcome to First Baptist Church Children Sunday School online program. How are you guys? I wish you all the best, and of course, you will be so exciting as Christmas is coming soon, and you will be very busy preparing your Christmas at home, right? Let's always have the joyful Christmas with you and your family. Let us worship our Lord together. To start our Sunday school online class. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the moment you have given us to gather and assemble online to learn more about you. Help us, Lord, in understanding. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So, do you have a plan for your Christmas? Are you doing special activities such as family gathering or going out somewhere for the holiday time? Wow, this time the holiday can get crazy. as now many places are open for the holiday season. So, do you have a plan? Christmas plan can be like a family party, sometimes also school activities, church activities, and you can have lots of activities during Christmas time. Christmas time is fun and will be chaotic if you don't have plan for it. Many times when things comes to the holiday, most of us will be going crazy because we are really fond of the holiday season. And we sometimes forgot to make a plan. So today, let's get some help planning ahead for one part of the holiday. What is that? A gift giving. If you were thinking you would like to make a gift for someone special, but you don't have any idea how to make it, let's see this picture. You can find it online on the web, and you can see how beautiful the gift giving, and you can find lots of guidance to make a gift to someone special. And you can recycle from the used things you have at home. Making and following plans, it's very crucial. However, sometimes it's not according to the plan. When it is not according to the plan, it will get messy, of course. Sometimes things just don't always turn out as what we plan. Today lessons, we are going to see how Mary and Joseph had plans for their future. But God had a bigger plan for them. Let's find them.
Long ago, God sent the angel Gabriel to a young woman named Mary. Mary was about to be wed to a man named Joseph, one of the descendants of King David. The angel said to Mary,
"Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you. Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end."
"How will this be, seeing that I have no husband?"
"The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she who was said to be unable to conceive is in her sixth month."
Just as the angel said, Jesus the Messiah was born. Before Mary and Joseph were married, Mary became pregnant through the power of the Holy Spirit. Many people ridiculed Joseph because his wife was pregnant outside of marriage, but because he was a good man, he did not want to disgrace Mary publicly. He decided to break their engagement quietly. One day, while Joseph was dreaming, an angel came to him and said,
"Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins."
When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him and stayed with Mary.
Well, we learned earlier that Joseph and Mary, they have their own plan for their future. They will get married and they will start their family life together. But God has a different plan for them. In the beginning, the plan it seems like chaotic to them. But through that situation, Mary and Joseph are devoted to God and they follow accordingly to what God has planned. And it turned very good, as the plan of God is for giving us the salvation. Let's see our memory verse today that is taken from Psalm 143, verse 10a. We will read that together. Teach me to do your will. You are my God. One more time. Teach me to do your will. You are my God. God was asking Mary and Joseph to put trust in him. And they did. This is the faith in action look like. We believe in God. And then we follow wherever he leads us. How can we know God's will for our lives? You're right. We will know God's will by reading a Bible and pray, of course, and also by personal relationship with God. Once we know God's plan, what should we do next? Again, you're right. You have to follow His way. You have to follow His lead. Let Him decide everything into our life. God's plan are bigger, greater, wonderful than anything we can dream up. God's plan brought His Son, Jesus Christ, to the earth. His amazing plan brought the Savior of the world, who can be our Savior if we choose to believe and follow Him. This week, let us beginning each of our day by praying to God and surrender our hearts and mind and our life into God's hands. Ask Him always to lead us to follow His plan for our life. Remember always that God is the one who provides everything in our lives. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your message today that reminds us that your plan is more bigger, greater, and wonderful than our plans. Thank you, Lord, to give us the salvation through Jesus Christ. Help us, Lord, always to believe you and to follow you in our life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, guys, thank you for joining our Children's Sunday School online program. See you next week. Have a blessed Sunday.